Cole, you bring up a great point, which is that the negotiating strategy here seems completely bogus to me. In other words, if the Senate Democrats start out with their opening bid essentially being that they're going to cut the program by $4 billion, and the House of Representatives, which is controlled by the Republicans, have a farm bill that they're about to pass this coming week, that they're going to cut the food stamps program by some
$20 billion over the next 10 years,
which will dramatically reduce eligibility for the program, throwing 2 million people off the rolls.
Right.
Tell us a little bit about that. Obviously, we're going to get something in the middle, but it really boggles the mind that the Senate Democrats would start with an opening bid of cutting the program.
Right. It does not bode well. But so the bill in the House, that what you just said is correct, that it's effectively going to throw 2 million people off the rolls of food stamps. Because basically right now there's this option, in most states provide this option. It's called categorical eligibility. And it means that if you have, as you mentioned before, the line is the threshold is 130% of the federal poverty line. So if your total assets, your total income, your gross income is above that, but your disposable income is below the federal poverty line, you can still receive SNAP benefits. And so this affects people primarily with high healthcare costs, childcare costs, people with, that live with seniors in the family, that have, high healthcare costs or childcare costs. And so these people, about 2 million Americans, under the current House bill are going to be thrown off food stamps. So not only are you getting those 2 million people, but additionally...
So those are folks, just to be clear, who have, under a certain provision, under the current rules for SNAP, for food stamps, folks that have disposable income under 130% of poverty because their primary expenses, such as healthcare and presumably maybe housing, render their disposable income less than that,
right,
would now be ineligible for the program completely.
Right.
And these are mainly folks that have people with disabilities in the family, people, seniors, high healthcare costs, those kinds of individuals. Now, you've also pointed out something in your article, which I encourage everyone to read in these times, and follow Cole Stengler on Twitter, at Cole Stengler, and in these times on Twitter, at In These Times Mag, and that is that by rendering these folks ineligible for food stamps at the federal level, they may also then become ineligible for food aid at the state level.
Right. I mean, so the free meals program, this affects children basically who, because of their eligibility, their household's eligibility for SNAP, are able to receive free meals provided by schools. And so this affects about a couple hundred thousand children are now going to lose their access to the free meals program because that eligibility is tied up with their household SNAP eligibility. So not only are you getting 2 million people thrown off SNAP, but you're also getting those additional couple hundred thousand of children now who are not going to be able to get the free meals program at their schools.
Cole, there are some conservatives that have claimed that President Obama is the food stamp president, and that as part of the stimulus, he expanded the eligibility requirements for the Supplemental Nutrition Assistance Program. Is this just rolling that back? I'm confused.
I mean, so you had that expiring. So you had additional boosts in food stamp eligibility because of the economic crisis and because of part of the stimulus. So that's expiring anyway. So these cuts are coming in addition to that immediate drop off.
Okay. So you're already seeing about. Just so we're clear, this $4 billion in cuts that the Senate Democrats are proposing is on top of an expiring expansion of eligibility that had been underway. It is not just offsetting that expansion in eligibility. Just so people are clear, the food stamps program, 47 million Americans depend on it directly. It's believed that many more Americans are food insecure,
right,
or somewhat hungry.